run, 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 run.
To get your bread.
Run, 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 run.
To live it all.
Run, 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 run.
Or you'll be dead.
I think that'll be enough of that one. Sounds pretty good to me. I thought it was a little scratchy.
Oh, no. It's good, Norm. Good.
Good. Very good intonation.
Say, Bill, how are we going to program that one? Do you think it'd be a good ending number?
Oh, that piece will go anywhere on the program.
I'd like to see it early in the program. For one thing, it might help to break down the notion that everything Bach wrote was cold, abstract, and without any feeling.
I think we owe it to the audience to let them know right away that most of these arias are tuneful and easy to listen to. Also, this piece is such a wonderful example of the influence of the old Italian opera on Bach, as you can see in this piece by Lagrenzi.
Lots of work to do.
You're right. I didn't mean to lecture.
Okay, what are we starting with?
Let's do that run from 113, the one we had trouble with the other day.
Any objections?
All right. You go first.
Okay, let's hear it.
Anybody got any gum?
Sure.
What kind is it?
Particular, isn't she?
Shh.
Okay, Julie.
Keep watching the accents. Keep them in the way you have them, but be careful not to hit them too hard.
Sure thing, Bill. How about trying it with voice?
I'm coming!
Let's start on line 20.
You have the balance problem licked.
Good enough for me. Are you satisfied?
Well, I'd like to work on it a bit, get it oiled up, but I think that's enough for now.
There's plenty of time before our next performance. You could polish it up at home. Next.
Well, how about 102?
I'm ready. Where do we start?
We rehearsed most of this last week, Maggie, up to about this measure. Da
di da da di da da di. Right. Da, da, give me two bars for nothing.
One bar.
You have to take it so much faster as long as you keep that spirit.
No, Gene, the spirit depends on the tempo. Anyway, we're not taking it fast. That's just the way it's marked. So
well,
I don't think
there's
any...
I hate to say this, but I've got to catch a train before midnight. It's beginning to sound like a debating society.
But think of the fun we have.
I think we should move on.
Okay. All right. 98.
Holman, don't say
we've never done this one before, have we?
No, that's a new one. This looks like a very nice little piece.
That's right.
Let's go.
Loud, it's too loud. You sing soft, that's no good either. He's instrumentalist.
Murray, what you're doing is very fine, but...
I think I know what you're going to say. I felt it, too. It's too smooth, too slight.
You've taken the words right out of my mouth.
I think it needs some more bravura, something to make it more robust.
I'm not sure he meant it to be that strong. Maybe it shouldn't be delicate, the way you've been playing it.
Well, let's play it once differently, and then we'll see.
Note 19, where Norm comes in.
All right.
Let's start. I guess you were right after all. This sounds much better.
The other was very pleasant, but this is much more exciting.
It's a different piece.
Exactly.
Well, that makes it unanimous. Pretty rare for the first try.
I guess it's my turn now. Can we try 84?
All right. I eat with joy my bit of bread. No, much too sweet. This should be lighthearted, but down to earth at the same time, Jean.
That's just what I'm trying for. On the surface, it seems so simple. But underneath, there's something strong. Something, I don't know.
Yes, yes. Just remember what it says. It's really very simple. Ich esse mit Freuden mein weniges Brot und gönne dem Nächsten vom Herzen das Seine. I eat with joy my bit of bread and am glad to let my neighbor have what is his.
Yes, that's just what I mean. I mean, I'd like to sing it so that if someone heard it, they could go through the day better. You know, not so agitated.
You mean fortified?
That's right, fortified.
Then take it a little faster, Jeannie.
Okay.
And articulate. Articulate.